Shopify for jewelry stores. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can use Shopify as your e-commerce partner when you are creating your online jewelry store and how Shopify can be a good fit for you or not. So let's get into it. Now, first off, you're just going to go on to shopify.com and you're going to click on start free trial over here, and you can have a 14-day free trial of Shopify, and you don't have to worry about your store name. You can change all of that later on. So once you have started with your free trial, this is going to be your basic dashboard once you have created your account. So on your left, you have your entire navigation. Then on your top right, you have your account setting. You can manage your account and you can create multiple stores from a singular account as well. So Shopify has a bunch of great features, but I'm just going to show you the features that I personally really like, and I'm going to go over the entire platform as a whole for you to create your own jewelry store or your own accessory store. And I was creating a scrunchie business last year, and I found some of these features to be so helpful in generally keeping data and managing my inventory. So first off, you need to go onto the product section, and if you already have a CSV file, you can just click on import over here, and you will be adding all of your existing products. If you don't have a file like that, you can just click on add product over here, and then you're just going to add the title of the product that you want. So we're creating a jewelry store, so I'm just going to do a few jewelry items. And then you have your description, so it could be 0.5 mm square cut, whatever detail you might want to add about the product, like so. And make sure your descriptions are actually accurate, because these are the descriptions that are going to appear on your actual website, so make sure you're writing your descriptions accordingly. Now after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this from a draft to an active product, and after that you're going to add your media file. So you can just click on add files over here and you can upload your file directly onto the Shopify platform. Below that you have your pricing. So this is something that I really found helpful when I was selling scrunchies, is that whatever price I added, I could also add my cost per item, and this would really help me manage my profit. So let's say we're going for $35 for this product, and then you can add a cost per item. So let's say if these earrings cost me around $20 to source, so I have a 42.9% profit margin, and I'm getting $15 of profit every time I sell one pair of earrings. And this is something that I find to be pretty useful, especially if you're selling small items like jewelry and accessories and scrunchies and all that. It's a lot more effective and efficient to have your cost per items calculated directly on Shopify. Now after that, you have your stock keeping unit, so you can add whatever SKU code you want. So you can add whatever SKUs you have, and then you can add barcodes as well. You can choose to track the quantity of your product or not, that's totally up to you, and you can choose to continue selling out of stock or not. So this is an option very helpful, and this feature is very helpful, especially if you're running a drop shipping business. So if you don't have your own products and you are just sourcing products from other places, you can definitely continue selling one out of stock. So let's say you have 100 items in stock, but you can order items and they would usually arrive in a week, so you can continue to sell this product even when it is out of stock, and then you can order more items as soon as you hit the margin where people are purchasing and you're already out of stock. So this is a great feature for you to continue sales even when you don't have any stock present. Then you add your shipping details and all of that, and then you can choose if this product has options. So let's say if this is a square cut ruby earrings, you can choose that maybe they have a certain style. So you could add the style, and then you could add the different values. So let's say I have a square cut, and then I could add the second option, which could be round cut, then it could be oval cut, whatever it might be. So you can add different values like that, and you're just going to click on done over here, and then you can change the prices for the item as well. So if you want the prices for one item to be more than the other, maybe a square cut is going to be a bit more expensive and then the round cut, you can also edit those on Shopify. So you can see over here now, after you have added all of your different variants, you can just click on edit website SEO to optimize the overall listing of how it is going to appear on Google or any other platform. platform. And now I'm just going to click on save and save this product that I have. And just like that, I have added my first product with different variations onto my product list. Now you can see that I have one product right now. Now below that, you can monitor your inventory for your products as well. Now this is more useful when you're running or operating on a larger scale. And if you're keeping track of items, multiple items, this is going to be a lot more useful for you. But for people that are just starting out, now if you go onto the analytics section over here, this is something that is going to be a very useful feature for you to monitor your overall success for your business, because over here you can see the average order values, total orders, our returning customer rate, online store sessions, how much time people are spending on your website, what kind of traffic are you getting, what people are actually purchasing the product, and what people are browsing. And you get all of those details directly from this singular dashboard, which is going to really help you in optimizing the business that you are running. Now below that, you have your reports as well, and these are a bit more detailed, and you can find a lot more information in the report section. So you can see in your report, you have your sales, you have acquisition, you have profit margins, you have customer behaviors, customers, and customer marketing, finances. All of that is present over here. And the most important I find out of all of this is your customer behavior. So if you go onto the customer behavior section, go into the show all section, you can find different specific reports for how customers are purchasing your products and whether they are just browsing, purchasing, what kind of devices they're using, all of that. Can find on in these reports, and these are some of the most important ones that I would definitely suggest that you check out frequently once you are running your own business here on Shopify. Now this was just for your overall business keeping. Then you have to build your storefront, so you're just going to click on online store over here, and then you're just going to scroll down. You're going to go into your theme library. You have explore free themes, and you can just explore any free theme that is provided by Shopify. If you are a bit more aware of HTML or any coding language, you can code your own website as well. But if you don't, just don't worry. You can just use any free theme you want. And then you're just gonna click on customize over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, first off, you can see this name over here. It's not changed from the website editor. So I'll show you guys how to change that later on. But what you're going to do is you're just gonna click on the section you want to change over here. You're gonna click on change image like this, and you can just click on free images. And make sure to click that link in the description box down below to get started with your own Shopify store. And the thing is that with Shopify, you can get started today. It's a free trial and you have nothing to lose. So that is why I suggest to everyone that is looking to start their business with Shopify that they do it today, because there is nothing to lose with Shopify. You're getting so many different features. You're getting so much for a very small price. Now, what I'm doing is I'm just changing some of these details on this template, jewelry for everyone, whatever tagline you have. And I think this looks pretty decent, so I'm just gonna leave it over there. And now you can see I have my page navigation. So if I go on to my product section, you can see these were the ruby earrings that I added. Obviously, I only have one product right now, so these are the only products that are appearing on my website. And this is so simple because the products are automatically going to be added to your website. You don't have to custom edit them or, you know, add your products individually onto the website. Now, once you have actually changed the overall look of your website however you want it to be, you're just going to click on save over here. Now, to change the name of your Shopify store, you can't do that from the editor, obviously. What you're going to do is you're going to go back into your dashboard. You're going to go into your settings down below at the left. You're just going to click on settings. And then you're just going to go into basic information. You're going to click on edit over here, and you're going to change the store name. So let's just say I have Clover Jewel. And then you're just going to click on save over here. And now my website has been edited. So you can see now it's called Clover Jewels and not the Baked Cakes template website. And if I actually go onto the catalog, and you can see these are the ruby earrings that I added. You can see it has square cut, it has round cut, oval cut, and it's all the same price. This is the description that I added. And this is how easy it is to create your own Shopify jewelry store. So make sure to check out the link in the description box down below to get started today. And make sure to like this video, hit the subscribe button, and I will catch you guys in the next video.